Hot Springs Village, Inside Out, the radio edition with your host, Dennis Simpson, here from the beautiful, and I mean beautiful, summer-soaked, sun-baked shores of Lake Desoto. The tornado mist, yeah, nicer weather. You know, hey, it's going to be a beautiful day, 94. Maybe 3 degrees too warm for me. I like the high 80s, but it's going to be beautiful, and it's going to be beautiful all the way through Thursday or Friday when we get that much needed rain again. You know how we are this time of year. Dennis Simpson, your host, and I am excited, very excited, that we've had Representative Bruce Westerman. Yes, that's right. Our national representative in the House of Representatives, who also happens to be the chair of the Natural Resources Committee. We talked about some big, big things on this interview with him, and we talked about some right down to earth, like the Albert Pike camping area that he wants to get reopened, and I want to get reopened too. It's a wonderful area. This is a fascinating interview. I can't wait for you to hear this. But first, some great fun music here on Hot Springs Village, Inside Out, the radio edition. Sometimes our guests say it better, about 2,000 times better. As an example,
the room is beautiful and homey. If you're looking for a relaxing, quiet getaway for a couple of days, this is the place.
Others say,
this was perfect for a relaxing weekend on the water. The hot tub was amazing at night because you could see all the fireflies everywhere. It was amazing.
And also,
the house is beautiful and cozy, very easy to roll in and feel right at home.
For over 8 years and 2,000 five-star reviews, D&D Village Properties have delighted to see our guests make great memories on the shores of Lake DeSoto.
Visit ddvillageprop.com today and reserve your getaway for you and your family. Soak in the hot tub, glide in the kayaks, or just sit and pet your fur baby as you watch the sunset. Call 501-350-0227 or visit online ddvillageprop.com.
You see this guy, this guy's in love with you. Yes, I'm in love. Who looks at you the way I do? When you smile, I can tell we know each other very well. How can I show you? I'm glad I got to know you, 'cause I've heard some talk. They say you think I'm fine. Yes, I'm in love. And what I do to make you mine, tell me now. Is it so? Don't let me be the last to know. My hands are shaking, let my heart break apart. I need your love. I
That's right. This guy is in love with you. I am talking to my beautiful, wonderful wife, Teresa Diana, who helped me celebrate my 60th birthday this year and had a wonderful vacation, had a wonderful birthday. Couldn't ask for more. And I mean that, could not ask for more. That was Mr. Herb Albert with the Tijuana Brass, if you read it like it says. And that is one of the few songs you will ever, ever, ever hear Herb Albert sing on. But of all the songs, I love that little soft medley. It's just beautiful. This guy's in love with you. Well, more great music coming up. Mr. Jackie Chandel coming up. And, you know, your love, well, it just keeps taking me higher and higher on Hot Springs Village, Inside Out.
his face again. That's why your love keeps on lifting me higher, higher and higher. I said your love keeps on lifting me higher and higher. All right.
And then you asked my five favorite places.
Yep.
So Lake Washita, I would say, is my favorite outdoor place to recreate.
That's a big place. That's 40,000 acres. Come on. Little Shangri-La, Three Sisters.
Well, I go to the north side of Lake Washita, so you'll find me at the big metropolises of Avant and Buck Bull, Iron Fort.
Greater Buckville, or is that kind of the burbs? Is that the burbs of Buckville?
Yeah, the burbs of Buckville. And, you know, or Possum Kingdom. If you go to the Navy Landing, you're just right outside of Possum Kingdom there. Sharon and I, my wife, went up there a couple of times, just took the boat up to Three Sisters last week and went out by ourselves and just floated around on a floaty in the lake. We hiked there at the state park at Three Sisters and got good and hot before we put the boat in and went out, played around in the water. I grew up, when I was a kid, family vacation was to put a tent in the boat and go out on an island and pitch a tent. And some of my best memories in life with my family and is out there on Lake Washita.
And what's the Blue Book value on that? What's the Blue Book value? Is that... priceless, I think that's the number.
Priceless, yeah. And then, you know, where my mom and dad's place is, where I grew up, they still live in the same house that I grew up in. And my dad's accumulated land, and we've got a hunting lease around it. So being out there on that property that I grew up hunting on.
And where's that near? Just near.
That's out off of Highway 128. Lonsdale's a mailing address. When I was a kid, there was 128 wasn't paved. It was 5 miles to the nearest piece of pavement. So we got our mail from Lonsdale. We got our electricity from Hot Springs, our phone from Benton. And I went to church at Owensville. So people would ask me, and I went to school at Fountain Lake. So they'd ask me, where did you grow up? And I said, in the sticks.
See, but you were multicultural. You didn't know it.
Yeah. So
I didn't mean to interrupt you. So that's two.
Those places are close to home. I love those. We just did a little short family vacation, and we got a cabin up in my district on the Buffalo River. Kids came in. When my kids were little, if you could say, would you like to go to Disneyland or float the Buffalo? Unanimous, float the Buffalo. You know, that was their favorite thing to do. So we went up and got a cabin, floated the Buffalo. We hiked out to Hawksbill Crag and got the pictures there. The most photographed place in the state. And it's beautiful any time of the year. But getting up there in the fall, when you can see the elk out there in Boxley Valley, all of that's in my district. And I say, I've got the... Nothing, no knock against the rest of the state, but most of the pretty places are in the fourth district.
Nobody scrambles to go to the Delta. Is that what you just said? That's what I heard you say.
Well, now the Delta, that would be on my list too. Duck hunting in the Delta, which yeah, I've got Jefferson County, probably the best duck hunting in the world's in my district.
Yeah, that's true. Goose hunting. That's true.
So that's other places I like to recreate. So I'm up to four. Yep. And then, this week when I leave DC, I'm actually going to a meeting in a really tough place at Glacier National Park. And, that's an amazing opportunity that I've had as chairing this committee with the Park Service under our jurisdiction. I'm constantly invited to go to parks to meet with the people out there. So I don't know if I can choose. I'll just say our national parks. But you got Glacier, Yellowstone.
Oh, yeah.
Green Canyon. Yeah. Yosemite.
Hot Springs.
And the jewel of the Park Service, Hot Springs National Park, Arkansas.
I wanted to, and once again, Bruce, thank you so much for your time. I wanted to make note when I read this little brochure, and I wanted to hold this back up real quick to let everybody know. Yeah, if you didn't get one of those in the mail, I'm sure your office would be happy. That's Congresswoman Westerman. One of the things I wanted to note here is that one of the articles where you talked about bureaucracy for the vendors, for the people that work with the Forest Service and whatever, first thing came to my mind was buffalo. These are hardworking mom and pops. This is not a mega corporation that rents out canoes. These are people that make money off the sweat of their brow. And then to be challenged sometimes by the
Park Service. Given the runaround by a massive federal government, when your livelihood depends on it. We had the bids went out again for the concessionaires on the Buffalo River, and we had to get involved in that. They were, again, a federal bureaucrat wanted to, in the name of relieving congestion, wanted to say that an outfitter couldn't drive your personal vehicle down the river to where you take your canoe or kayak out because they were going to reduce traffic. Well, what they didn't understand was they were going to double traffic because people would end up taking one vehicle and putting it at the takeout, and they'd put another vehicle at the put-in. They were going to interrupt business because nobody wants to get out of the river wet and tired and have to wait for the next shuttle to come along, then get shuttled back to the put-in, which may be an hour drive back up or 45 minutes or whatever. They want to get in their car, get dry clothes on, get on the road and go get something to eat or go back and relax. So, again, they took the local input out of it. But we were able to step in and make the concerns of these vendors known, and we got that back where they can still shuttle your car down to the takeout.
A law of unintentional consequences. And I'm certain when you get to Glacier National Park, somebody's going to have a story a lot like that to tell you.
Yep, it happens all over the country. And another big, I apologize, I kind of got off chasing rabbits, but we barely touched on everything in the Explore Act. A big problem out west, these massive parks and having housing for the workers. So the gateway communities, there's stuff in here to help the gateway communities. Like you going into Yellowstone, if you're coming down out of Bozeman, Montana, the workers, for the most part, live outside the park, although there's some housing in the parks. But trying to make it where there's affordable housing, where the facilities are better. The construction cost inside these parks is four times what it's in other places. And a lot of it's because it's remote, and other parts because of the regulations that they put in place to get stuff done. So we're trying to interject some common sense and good ideas into our public lands so that more people can enjoy them.
Bruce Westerman, it has been a delight. We'll make it sooner next time. Okay.
You bet. You just let us know. And, there'll probably be something else to talk about.
I tell you what, we can come back and finish this one. Congressman Westerman, again, thank you for your time. We'll see you next time.
Thank you, Dennis.
Business owner, do you have a 10-year-old phone system? Well, let us tell you about Total Telco, the local Hot Springs Village telephone provider. hate working with a multinational corporation that really doesn't care if you use them or not, who have one plan and it's designed to wrestle as much money out of your pocket as possible for as long as possible, Total Telco has great news. We offer free new phones. You heard that right. New color, HD quality, caller ID, voicemail, call forwarding, conferencing phones that sound great, 99.9% uptime that'll make you sound great to your clients for free. With the savings that you'll receive from signing up with Total Telco today, you can pay for completely new phones that'll make your life so much easier. Total Telco uses state-of-the-art cloud-based systems to make sure you never miss a call, even if your power is out. Our state-of-the-art cloud-based system will record your message and send you an email message of that missed call with the power out. Great prices, amazing quality, superior service. Total Telco of Arkansas. Reach us at 501-350-0227. Let us show you why the Beehive, Christ of the Hills Church, Woodlands Presbyterian, Granada Mexican Grill, Village Chiropractic, and over 300 locations are Total Telco customers. Again, call us today. It's Total Telco of Arkansas, 501-350-0227. Again, it's 501-350-0227. We are Total Telco of Arkansas.
Yeah.
Sometimes our guests say it better. About 2,000 times better. As an example.
The lake is beautiful and homey. If you're looking for a relaxing, quiet getaway for a couple of days, this is the place.
Others say
this was perfect for a relaxing weekend in the water. The hot tub was amazing at night because you could see all the fireflies. Everywhere. It was amazing.
And also,
the house is beautiful and cozy, very easy to roll in and feel right at home.
For over 8 years and 2,000 five-star reviews, D&D Village Properties have delighted to see our guests make great memories on the shores of Lake Desoto.
Visit ddvillageprop.com today and reserve your getaway for you and your family. Soak in the hot tub, glide in the kayaks, or just sit and pet your fur baby as you watch the sunset. Call 501-350-0227 or visit online ddvillageprop.com.
Dennis Simpson, 25 past it. Dennis Simpson here, Hot Springs Village Inside Out, 92.9 KVRE, and streaming live, as you know, on iHeart. That was Mr. Gordon Sumner. Now, Mr. Sumner was the great-great-grandson of a executioner's Sumner, and that's a summoner in England. And what he would do is that he would call people to the gallows. Well, Mr. Gordon Sumner, his great-great-grandson, used to wear yellow and black striped sweaters. Yep, and he wore those sweaters so that he could sing with a group called the Police. And so with those yellow and black striped sweaters, we might have called him, I don't know, Charlie Brown. But no, his friends, they called him Sting. Mr. Gordon Sumner. More great music coming up here at 30 past the hour in Hot Springs Village. Your wonderful partners here from the Sun Baked. And man, lots of boats going up and down the lake this weekend. I tell you, it's a beautiful, beautiful time of week here. You need to be here. More great music from Hot Springs Village.
Sometimes
That was Mr. Chris Cross. You may know him from the song Sailing, and it seemed like every song he had there for a while had a backup vocal by Mr. Michael McDonald. I keep forgetting we're not in love anymore. I do like Mr. Michael McDonald. We saw a great concert with them on YouTube the other night. Man, you know, music, it just comes from every place these days. Now, yeah, how about American Idol? How about a finalist on American Idol? And the guy's name is Chance Beckham. And he's from California, but he sounds like a Southern boy to me because his next song that I love, You Don't Have to Tell Me Twice. Yeah, that's a Southern saying, isn't it? You don't have to tell me twice. KVRE, Hot Springs Village, Inside Out.
Side, then I lost it, burnt my reputation in my own hometown. I learned the value of a dollar cause I had to work for it, and roll my windows up when the rain is pouring down. But from where I'm sitting now, I've learned a hell of a lot from taking good advice, but a whole lot more just from living life. You don't gotta tell me twice to take a day off when you need the rest. Loosen up, drag on 2 pounds less. Drink a cold beer when the weather's right. But you don't gotta tell me twice to spend your time off with the ones you love and sending up prayers to the man above. Say you know how it goes after every low comes a high. Yeah, that's life. You better hold on. Twice. No, you don't have to tell me twice. Thought I knew about love when I was 17. I cared more about her than I cared about me. Had to learn how to walk the line, like Johnny said. You better call your mama, don't let her call you. Don't lie to your daddy, he knows when it ain't the truth. He's the one who knows you best. He says you're gonna get burned if you try to set the world on fire. And don't look down if you're walking on wires. You don't gotta tell me twice to take a day off when you need the rest. Loosen up, drag on 2 pounds less. Drink a cold beer when the weather's right. No, you don't gotta tell me twice. Just spend your time off with the ones you love and sending up prayers to the man above. Say you know how it goes after every low comes a high. Yeah, that's life. You better hold on and hold on tight. But you don't have to tell me twice. Drink a cold beer when the weather's right. No, you don't gotta tell me twice. Just spend your time off with the ones you love and sending up prayers to the man above. Say you know how it goes after every low comes a high. Yeah, that's life. You better hold on and hold on tight. But you don't have to tell me twice. Twice.
Well,
see, all of us have responsibilities. You don't have to tell me twice, call your mama, don't lie to your daddy. Come on. These are the basics, right? I'm telling you, he sounds like a real country boy to me for somebody that grew up in California. Chase Beckham, if you get a chance to take a look around and talk to him, he's a great, great interview. A wonderful guy. Had quite a story to tell. Speaking of a story, Mr. Alan Jackson has a story. He told his mama one time that if I ever made it big, mama, someday I will record you a gospel album. Well, not only did he record a gospel album and fulfill his promise, but you see, it sold millions of copies, so he made a second gospel album. One of his albums is called Alan Jackson Precious Memories. And I love this one because, my friends, just like Mr. Jackson, I love to tell the story.
I love to tell the story of unseen things above, of Jesus and His glory, of Jesus and His love. I love to tell the story because I know 'tis true. It satisfies my longings as nothing else can do. I love to tell the story. 'Twill be my theme in glory to tell the old, old story of Jesus and His love. I love to tell the story for those who know it best. Same hungering and thirsting to hear it like the rest. And when in scenes of glory I sing the new song, 'twill be the old story that I have loved so long. I love to tell the story. 'Twill be my theme in glory to tell the old story of Jesus and His love. To tell the old story of Jesus and His love.
Hope you enjoyed that as much as I did, Mr. Alan Jackson. That's a beautiful, and there's just an old country church and him sitting on the front porch on the album cover. That was a wonderful song. And I tell you what, frankly, we all need a little of that. Matter of fact, if you'll remember, it is 43 past the hour, and Mr. Chris, Reverend Chris, at the Village United Methodist Church, yeah, he's going to be next, and he always has a wonderful sermon. I enjoy Reverend Chris. More great music coming up. Hey, listen, and it's 43 past the hour. What are we doing with this 94-degree day? Get out and enjoy it, would you? If you're not on your way to church now. Dennis Simpson, Hot Springs Village, Inside Out.
You can play the game. You can act out the part. Though you know it wasn't written for you. Tell me, how do you stand there with your broken heart, ashamed of playing a fool? When one thing can lead to another, it doesn't take any sacrifice now. Oh, father and mother and sister and brother, if it feels nice, don't think twice. Shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Things are gonna be just fine if we only will. All I really mean to say is shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Things are gonna be much better if we only will. You can run, but you cannot hide. No, this is widely known. And what you plan to do with your foolish pride when you're all by yourself alone? Won't you tell somebody the way that you feel? You can feel it beginning to ease. I think it's true what they say about the squeaky wheel always getting grease. Get dirt to shower the people you love with love. Show them the way. Things are gonna turn out right if we only will. If we only will, what's now?
Show the people you love with love.
You got to show them the way that you feel. Yeah.
Things are gonna be much better
if we only.
The words of Brother James Taylor here on a beautiful Sunday morning, 48 past the hour already. How did we do that? But you know, he sends some great advice. Shower the people you love with love. Really? Really? Why not? Will it embarrass you if you do? Will you regret it? Will you say, I shouldn't have shown him I loved him. I shouldn't have told him I loved him. I shouldn't have been so kind and compassionate and sharing my feelings. Really? Yeah, I don't think there's anything to regret. Mr. Taylor helping us on a beautiful Sunday morning. Yeah, and then Mr. Tisdale. Now, Mr. Tisdale was a saxophone trombonist, and also, yeah, an NBA basketball star. He was friends with Mr. Toby Keith. Let's hear Mr. Tisdale with a version of Get Down On It. It's hard to change your life. It's hard to pick up the pieces and start all over again. It's hard getting your mind together after you've gone through a life-shaking experience, maybe being a primary caregiver for someone or hearing a good diagnosis you didn't want, or starting over after a loss of any kind, being alone in a new place and wanting a friend. But you can do hard. You can weather the storm. You will come through this. Affirm yourself this every day, several times a day, no matter how hard it gets. I'm going to make it. stand up inside yourself and look in your eyes and say, I can do hard. Exercise, pray, seek solitude. Allow for periods of sadness, but know that you will get through this event. Keep the faith, continue to work, and expect to make it through. You may not be able to change your circumstances or situation, but you can change the one thing you can change, yourself. You can change you. Hold on. You can do hard. You have greatness within you. By Mr. Les Brown. For those of you who have heard me talk about Les Brown for the last 2 years, and to read some of his motivational sayings, and you've heard me tell about how he was born to a prostitute on a concrete floor in a warehouse with him and his twin brother in South Miami, and his adopted mother was a servant worker or a service worker for households in South Miami. You've heard me tell all that. What you didn't hear is that this is what he wrote after he was diagnosed with prostate cancer. You see, it's easy for us to look at people who, well, you know, maybe they're having a bad day or something, but they're positive. No, he had a tough life. He's a tough guy. And he never gave up. He never quit. Because you can do hard. He can do hard. We all can. It's all within your grasp. Dennis Simpson, Hot Springs Village Inside Out, again, and it is a delight to have you with us. Come join us again next week when we all will want just one more day. See you next week.
Last night I had a crazy dream. Wish was granted just for me. It could be for anything. I didn't ask for money or imagine Malibu. I simply wished for one more day with you. One more day. One more time, one more sunset, maybe I'd be satisfied. But then again, I know what it would do. Leave me wishing still for one more day with you. First thing I do is pray for time to crawl. I'd unplug the telephone, keep the TV off. I'd hold you every second, say a million I love yous. That's what I do with one more day with you. One more day, one more time, one more sunset, maybe I'd be satisfied. But then again, I know what it would do. Leave me wishing still for one more day with you. One more day, one more time, one more sunset, maybe I'd be satisfied. But then again, I know what it would do. Leave me wishing still one more day. One more day. Leave me wishing still one more day.
with you.